people, help the community. Our goal is to make Baltimore a safe place.
Right.
I want kids to be able to play.
Yes, I want to be able to do things besides going to work and then going straight home.
Wow.
You know, like you, it's realistic. Like you just, ain't nobody going to stay somewhere where they know they can possibly get shot.
I know.
You know, like that's why people are so quick to leave Baltimore, but it is a wonderful place. There's so much talent here. Like it really is.
We met y'all. Y'all singing.
Right. I'm
so if y'all leave, y'all going to be gone.
How we going to leave?
Y'all, we need y'all to push the Eyes in the Sky program.
Right. Yeah. See, that way you don't have to leave.
Right. Definitely. Because I have a little sister and I definitely look over her and I wanted her to be great, you know?
Right.
But you wonder what people going to go through, like when they're not home, like whether they come in contact with somebody with a gun or you know, get robbed or whatever. You never know. It's scary. It's Toy, really scary.
Toy, you leaving too? Toy just joining us. Toy, how you doing?
I'm doing all right. How about yourself?
Okay. Are you planning on leaving or are you going to college? What's going on with you?
Well, I'm going to college actually in the heart of the city. I'm going to Micah.
So. Micah?
I love that college.
You love Micah?
I wanted to go there. It's art college.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, my Toy, can you quickly tell us what's going on with you?
So,
you've been accepted to Micah?
Oh, yeah. I got accepted, and we actually just went to open house this past Sunday, and it didn't do anything but invigorate me to, like, I just want to go more. So, I've been on my grind out here looking for these scholarships and applying and stuff. But,
you know, Dr. Ross, just the same gentleman was on like a couple weeks ago, and it cost $50,000 to go. But Micah just gave you what, $28,000 last week to come, and you about what, $19,000? What I was short. Tell us about it. What happened?
In total, I got more than that. But the amount that they gave me, I ended up getting 3 scholarships. 2 of them, I remember the names too. One of them I don't right now, but one of them is the Creative Vision Award, and another one's called the Da Vinci Award, and then there's the third one. All together, I'll be getting $28,000 a year, and that's for to go for 4 years. But
yes, congrats! Even still,
that's not congratulations!
So I'm still out here looking.
So tell us, how can people to help you? You short of what? Like, how much you short just to get you in the first year?
Just for tuition, I would need about $23,000 more.
Mm-hmm.
$23,000 more. If I wanted to stay on campus, because the reason that I'm pushing to stay on campus is because commuting back and forth between Mike and home
don't
is
tell
pretty
me.
Risky.
Oh, I don't my have goodness. My I knew you was going to say that. He said it's risky to commute back and forth.
Where do you live? Well, not where you live. But.
Yeah, he says risky. He'd rather stay on campus than travel the streets of Baltimore.
Yeah.
So that's sad.
I would have to take the bus, and I would have to end up in some places that I would have to stand on corners in places that I'm not really familiar with down in West Baltimore areas like that. Yeah. So I would rather just be on campus. So I don't
unless
really
we
have
get
to
eyes in the sky here, and then the streets can be safe, and then you can save money by staying home. But put out information where people can help and support you. Do you have a Cash App or, you know, Instagram or something?
Yes, I actually do have a Cash App. It's just my full name, Tory Lomax Pay. Mm-hmm. TORYLOMAX.
Spell it again.
It's just my full name, Tory Lomax Pay.
And that's spelled?
TORYLOMAXBEY.
And somebody needs to call you or communicate with you, how can they do so?
You can send me an email. I have a few, but the one that you can send me an email is lomax.k.tory@gmail.com.
Okay. That's social media?
No, that's just my email account.
So tell us about quickly, now You major in art, right? That's an art. That's a fine. That's one of the greatest in the country.
Micah? Yeah, this is a wonderful college.
You heard about Micah?
I always wanted to go there.
My uncle went there. Actually.
Your uncle went there?
Oh, no. Micah is world renowned. It's one of the real big ones.
Mm-hmm.
They got one here. Something like that, right?
Yeah, right on North Avenue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's the one he's going to.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And you wanted to go there, too?
I did. What happened? Because I also draw, so.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, and I wanted to go there, but, I didn't get a scholarship for them, but, I just mainly started focusing on my music, too, so.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a really good college. I really hope you do well there, because this is a big opportunity.
All right, Toy. So, once again, tell us quickly about the scholarship, and you got it, and you hopefully that you can get everything so you can continue going, if you can. I pray that you will.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. It'll be a bit easier once I get in for my first year, because at Open House, they actually opened up about a little bit more about how getting scholarships and stuff works at MICA. And honestly, it's harder to get in your first year because you don't have the connections that MICA would be able to give you if you were there. So if they're actually really generous with their money, and if you talk to the right people, there's a bunch of competitive scholarships and different competitions that you can apply for, and just really things that the teachers themselves, you know, like everybody has their own, everybody that's a teacher at MICA actually has two jobs. They're a teacher at MICA and they do something else, not on the side, but they're working two full-time jobs. So they're full-time artists as well as full-time teachers. So they would have plenty of connections for you to be able to take advantage of when you get in, and that could lead to more money to go for the rest of your years.
Okay.
So it's really just the first year. Once I get through that, it should be pretty downhill.
Alright. Well, just keep checking with us and call us next week and see if anyone called you, connect with you, and just keep us informed. Okay?
Alright. Thank you.
Anything you'd like to say, Dr. Ross?
I think that's great. I mean, getting the young folks into colleges, into education. You don't need education. You don't need college, but, you know, it's a great thing that they can get there. And, I spent a lot of time in college. I was fortunate. I got the Air Force to help pay for a lot of it. I got my schools to help pay for a lot of it. And sometimes you can actually grow up to be an overeducated delinquent and still try to do good.
Uh-oh. You didn't say a delinquent.
Well, never mind. I was once a long time ago.
So you wasn't a good guy all the time.
Well, I struggled. I ended up with under a 2.0 GPA.
Don't hang up, and, Toy. Someone wanted to speak to you. So Albert Deuce is going to talk to you. Okay, Toy?
All right.
All right, hold on.
So I'm getting in. That's a great, great opportunity. And I wish you the best of luck. And we'll see what we can do to help.
Okay. Wonderful. Mark C., what's going on?
Hey, how you doing? I was on my way to a viewing, and I was listening to this wonderful show, man. I had to pull over and call in. You know, I want our young people to know there's hope. You know, there's a lot of people out here that have grassroots and that's doing things. But, you know, they sound discouraged because they say, you know, that we're not investing in our young people. That's what I'm hearing them say. And we should have been had eye in the sky. But also, we have a $12 million youth fund.
Don't tell me that. How can they get $12
million? Every year, that Jack Young put in place to go to go into the budget every year, the youth fund, that didn't go to the grassroots that it should have went to.
So y'all can get some of that $12 million. They want to know about this. Let them know.
Let me ask you a question.
Go ahead.
One in a million.
If you have a youth fund, everybody in there, if you have a youth fund, what's the two key words? Youth
fund.
Which means you should be doing everything to help the 1,500 young people that's homeless at night. The 3,200 young people that's homeless in school. Now you got buildings, I've been told you.
Yeah. We took pictures of it today on Broadway and North Avenue.
Oh, it's right there.
That's apartment building, Larry.
We're trying to get that.
That could be turned into
a studio.
Turned into studio apartments for homeless young people to wrap around services. Studio apartments. For homeless young people to wrap around services.
All right. Well, wonderful, Mark. See, where can they find you at on Sundays?
Every second and fourth Sunday, Larry. at 5 o'clock, and man, I got some shows coming up.
Maybe we get the youth on your show too, so they can sing.
Every second and fourth Sunday, I'll be
talking about that $12 million.
Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna be talking about all that, brother.
All right, believe me. Let us know, Mark.
All right, take care.
Appreciate you. And let's go to Still on a Bad Day. Is it a bad day or a good day? Manuel Ringo. What's up? Manuel. The Manuel drop. Dr. Rosman Nutt, back to you. And you, I can't know that name for nothing.
Tashira Regal.
Tashira Regal. I hope I don't chop you up. So, what are you going to be singing before we go off again? So my producer can, like, get it together. What song do you think she can sing?
What about can, Listen?
Listen?
That's by Beyonce.
Really? So maybe we can get Beyonce so she can get in touch with you so y'all can do something.
I would die.
For real?
I will die.
Wait
what?
A minute. Maybe y'all going to open stage or open up or something.
Man, if I open up for Beyonce, that's the day I will lose my mind.
What song can you sing close to hers right now so she can open up with you if she say okay? I'm just saying.
What song?
You know you on Radio 1 Network?
Man, I already sung 1 plus 1, man. I'm going to sing Beyonce. Listen, yeah.
Okay.
Turn that thing on.
All right. Well, after when Dr. Ross would not put out some good information, then Jason going to put that song on. It's called Listen. And see if somebody can get in touch with Beyonce.
Definitely.
So she can turn this on.
Yeah, get in touch with B. Come on, B.
Rodericos, maybe you can hit that button so Jay-Z and I can listen to your name again.
Tashira Regal.
Uh-huh. And how can they reach you?
You can reach me on Instagram. I am Tashira Regal.
Okay, so we can do a instrumental for...
Listen.
Mm-hmm. And you can hit it just like that.
Yeah.
All right, Jason going to do it.
I'm going to do it.
Get it.
All right. Then Dr. Ross.
Yes, sir.
We had a couple of youth. Now, the one that called in, he's going to Micah.
Yeah.
And he don't even want to commute because of his safe streets. So you definitely got to come on up here with the plane, man, and get the city together.
I spent a lot of time on North Avenue, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
And all those other things, and, you know, it doesn't feel that safe.
Wow.
And, I've gotten used to it, but I live in a community here. I don't even have a key to my house.
You don't have a key to your house.
I do not have a key to my house.
Oh, because he lives somewhere else. We need keys for our house.
I want people to be able to leave their bikes on their porch. I want people like Miss Pinky to be able to sit.
For Baltimore. Yeah, things gonna get back right.
I mean, it is Friday night. You know, you do have Natty Daddies out there. Archie keeps buying them for me, and you ought to be able to sit around. And at Pennsylvania Avenue should be a nightlife. You know, all the jazz clubs and everything else that used to be there. I mean, I'd rather have jazz clubs on Pennsylvania Avenue than strip joints on Baltimore Avenue. You know?
Right.
People enjoying life, enjoying each other, and not worried about things. When we had all our meetings up there
you standing up or sitting down?
At the church there on the Baptist church up there, where the community leaders were afraid to leave their house to come meet with us. Mm. Because, again, they were afraid of
afraid
of leaving their house after 6 o'clock. And it's like, you're kidding me. You're almost a prisoner in your own home there.
Dr. Rossman, I'll put the website up and put up information where people can go on here and sign the petition so they can get this up in the sky.
The best place there is Archie's website, which is communitywithsolutions.com. That's communitywithsolutions.com. There's a sign up there for an endorsement. You can also go into that. It's the Solution 1.
Uh-huh.
And you can also go in there and you click on the more information page. You can actually see how we go about solving murders. You can learn about all the privacy protections that we have in place. You can see how
you can't tell who a person is. You can only tell where they come from and where they go to. And by doing that, we protect people's privacy. We can tell everywhere our analysts have looked. All that's recorded and reviewable. We hold police accountable. We also offer jobs. We'd be hiring about 30 to 35 people within the city of Baltimore to learn these skills. After a couple of years, we tend to lose them.
Mm-hmm.
Once they get their security clearances, they get jobs that pay 4 to 5 times more over at the National Security Agency and other things. There's 26,000 jobs in the defense analyst jobs in the Baltimore area.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't get those jobs without experience. You can't get the experience without the job.
So he got jobs, too, if y'all need them. You got jobs?
Where do I apply?
Where do you apply?
Where do I apply?
Well, as soon as we get out, we work with a group from Baltimore Cyber Range and Baltimore Community College to get qualified people from the community. Just about everybody we work will be using out there will come from the city of Baltimore. Okay. We'll bring a few experts who have got a lot of experience from out here doing this, and we train people up, give them the skills they need, and essentially our job is to teach these young folks everything they need to know. We give them increasing responsibilities. We teach them everything from work ethic to PowerPoint to our particular computer programs that we use. But those skills basically make them very employable as defense analysts. And again, there's 26,000 jobs right down at Fort Meade, up at Aberdeen, in that area that pays 70 to 80 to 90 thousand
a year.
And we'd like to become a pipeline for providing those jobs to people from the inner city who otherwise wouldn't be eligible for those because they don't have the experience.
Okay. Well, Dr. Rossman, don't touch that dial. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back. Yeah, we'll be right back.
Listen to the song here in my heart. A melody as starred, but can't complete. Listen to the sound from deep within. It's only beginning to find release. Oh, storm has come for my dreams to be heard. They will not be pushed to the side and turned into your own, all 'cause you won't listen. Someone here inside, someone I thought had died so long ago. Oh, screaming out, and my dreams will be heard. They will not be pushed to the side or worse into your own, all 'cause you won't listen. You made of me.
Auntie Williams.
Yes. He shocked the world.
Yo, I'm
shocked
tight.
The world.
Auntie Williams, you like that?
Man, I'm so sorry. I could not participate in today's show, but I've been listening. But, you know, social services, you're not allowed to use your phone. Oh. So, you know, I apologize. But, man, this has been a great show. I have to be here. You have carried the weight, my friend, as you do always.
Oh, my goodness.
And then you top it off with listen. Listen does not just mean to us ourselves. It means to listen to us, to the leadership. Somebody has to listen to our cry. Wow. We cannot just go over and over. We pray, we sit down, we kneel down every day, all day. Those of us that are really true activists, we do this every day, all day. But we are truly asking for the people to listen. It's the people that has the power to listen.
Wow. Auntie topped it off, Dr. Ross Manutt. Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. There it is, y'all. Well, we thank everybody for coming out. We're going to leave. We're still on a bad day. Archie, yep. Williams, put the information out there.
So, Community with Solutions is, man, turn the cameras around. I can't say that enough, like Pastor Simmons does, but that is our information, communitywithsolutions.com. It's the website, and we have a very, very good opportunity for the city all the way around. Totally wrap around arms. That's what we do.
What's the website, Archie?
CommunityWithSolutions.com.
Dr. Ross, thank you.
Can I do a quick shout-out?
You got 30 seconds.
Oh, I want to give a shout-out to No Limit Communications. It's the cell phone store on Greenmount Avenue. The address is 3048 Greenmount Avenue. We specialize in cell phone services, so definitely come through. And you can see me. You can meet me. Oh, that's your cell phone store.
Go ahead. What's the address?
3048 Greenmount Avenue.
What's the name of it?
No Limit Communications.
What you got there?
Cell phone services. We unlock phones, all that. You know, come through. You can see me.